I wonder what you'll say tomorrow. I wonder what you'll write in your newspapers and magazines tomorrow. Will you give God the glory? Will you give God the glory? You allow me to speak even though you don't like what I may say. That a work has been done in you today, unlike any work that's ever been done in this great city.
Your brother, but I come in the line like those ancient worthies. I'm in the most powerful government that ever was in the last 6,000 years. I want you to listen well now.
So
if I survive. Like a lamb in the midst of ravenous beasts. If I survive, then the power that backs me is greater than the powers that are against me. God is in person today. Remember what I said at the beginning? I talked about a problem no man could solve. And I talked about a power that nobody could deal with. Where's the problem that no scientist can solve? Here we are, 30 to 40 million black people who have been turned upside down and inside out. 30 to 40 million black people who don't know who they are, don't know where they are, don't know what time it is, don't know who their God is, don't know what their religion is, but are trusting in the God of their slave master.
Farrakhan, you sound a little hypocritical. Because you around here teaching all that black stuff. So ain't that racism? No. That's the antidote for racism. Now, why is it an antidote? Hold on. Why is it an antidote? White people think you're better because you're white. Black people think you're less because you're black. The truth of black and white will settle the question. What is the truth? How old is the white man? No. Let's deal with facts. How old are white people?
Well, we came from...
Go ahead, theorize, talk to me. There's no sign of you, talking to white people, in any part of the earth other than Europe. There's no sign of you in Asia. There's no sign of you in Africa. There's no sign of you in Central America, South
South America, the Caribbean, everywhere you went, you were a discoverer because you are new on our planet. So where did you come from? Muslims, don't be upset, Muslims. The Quran deals with color too. But it doesn't deal with color in a manner that any of us can take our color as a badge of superiority. Because superiority is not measured by color, skin texture. Superiority is measured by one's duty to God. Huh? But the Quran clarifies the issue of color. Let's see what we're talking about. Allah says in the Quran, I'll get to the Bible in a minute, bear with me. He says, I, God, created man. From what? The Quran says, black mud, fashioned into shape. I don't speak Arabic, so there's Arab scholars, all your translations say black mud. Now, if it's white, it can't be mud. Hello. We all right? Sure. We gonna mess up this old racist talk. Says fashioned into shape, and he called the man Adam. Adam is the father of all living men. Eve is the mother of all living creatures. Now, if Adam was made from black mud, and the Quran says, Allah created man from a single essence and his mate of the same kind. And the scholars admit in their research that Eve was a black woman. So Adam, the original Adam, had to be... can I get a witness? Had to be a black man. Now that hurts. I know it hurts. Some light-skinned people in the audience.
What? Is that true?
See, I'm challenging white supremacy now. I'm challenging light-skinned supremacy with truth. From the Quran, God started it off, black mud. Then he said, I breathe into him of my inspiration. And when I made him complete, I said to the angels, make obeisance to him. He told the angels, bow down to a black man. And all the angels